Hello everyone, myself Arpita Patil, Assistant Professor, Department of Zoology from Srimati Indira Gandhi Government First Grade Women's College, Sagara. In today's video, I am going to explain about the immune system. Immunology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of the ways in which the body defends itself from infectious agents and other foreign substances in its environment. The immune system protects us from pathogens. Our immune system is essential for our survival. Without an immune system, our body would be open to attack from bacteria, viruses, and other parasites. It is our immune system that keeps us healthy as we drift through a sea of pathogens. In environment, there are lots of pathogens. It is as if we are drifting through a sea of pathogens, and it is our immune system that keeps us healthy. This vast network of cells, tissues is constantly on the lookout for invaders. And once an enemy is spotted, a complex attack is mounted. The immune system is spread throughout the body, and it involves many types of cells, tissues, organs, protein, etc. Immune system can distinguish self tissue from non-self tissue. The immune system has the ability to discriminate or differentiate between the individual's own cells and harmful invading organisms. It also recognizes and clears dead and faulty cells are also recognized and cleared away by the immune system. There are two types of immunity. Innate immunity, it is also called as non-specific immunity, and second type is adaptive or specific immunity. It is also called as acquired immunity. Let's study the types one by one. First one is innate or non-specific immunity. We are all born with some level of immunity to invaders. Human immune systems, similarly to those of many animals, will attack foreign invaders from day one. This innate immunity includes the external barriers of our body, the first line of defense against pathogens, such as the skin and mucous membrane of the throat and gut. This response is more general, and this is non-specific. Innate immunity is general and non-specific. If the pathogen manages to dodge the innate immune system, adaptive or acquired immunity kicks in. First, study the characteristics of innate immunity. First one is, it is called as first line of defense because we are all born with the innate immunity, and it is called as first line of defense because when any invader or foreign agent enter into the body, innate immunity starts its function. Therefore, it is called as first line of defense. And innate immunity is very rapid in its function, and it is always same on re-exposure to antigen, and there is no immunological memory. There is absence of memory cells, or there is no immunological memory in case of innate immunity, and it recognizes and reacts against microbes only. It also blocks the entry of microbes and eliminate succeeded microbes with which entered the host. It is able to block the entry of microbes and eliminate succeeded microbes which entered the host. Now, let's study the different components of innate immunity. They are called as barriers, and these barriers are classified into three types: physical barriers, mechanical barriers, and chemical barriers. First one, physical barriers. Physical barriers, they will protect against invasion of microbes. For example, epidermis of the skin, epithelium of mucous membrane, and cilia, all these are considered as physical barriers. Second one is mechanical barriers. Here it includes the longitudinal flow of air and fluid, and also the movement of mucus by cilia. These are considered as
mechanical barriers. Next one is chemical barriers. For example, alpha and beta defensins. These are the chemicals secreted by our body. They are called as alpha and beta defensins. They are chemical barriers. And one more is lysosome, present in lacrimal fluid or the tear, that protects us, our eyes, from different microorganisms. And hydrochloric acid of stomach also kills the ingested microbes. Now, let's study about the adaptive or specific immunity. It is also called as acquired immune system. This protects from pathogens, develops as we go through life. As we are exposed to diseases or get vaccinated, we build up a library of antibodies to different pathogens. This is sometimes referred to as immunological memory, because our immune system remembers previous enemies or antigens. Therefore, it is called as immunological memory. Let's study the characteristic of adaptive or specific immunity. It is called as second line of defense, because when the innate immune system fails to destroy the foreign microbe or any foreign agent, then second line of defense or adaptive immune system come to action. Therefore, it is called as second line of defense. And in case of adaptive immune system, the response is very delayed to infection. And it is very specific for microbes and antigen. It can differentiate different antigens. Therefore, it is called as specific. And it has memory cells or immunological memory, which remember microbes and give strong immune response on re-exposure of any antigens or microbes. Next you are going to study about the components. Here, these components are divided into sequential phases. Antigen recognition by lymphocytes through specific receptors to antigen. Lymphocytes are the WBCs. There are different types of WBCs, and they have specific receptors on them, and these receptors can recognize antigen. When lymphocyte recognize antigen, there is an activation of lymphocyte. After activation, lymphocytes, they will start their proliferation by division, mitotic cell division. They will proliferate, and after proliferation, they will differentiate into two types of cells: memory cells and effector cells. Effector cells are the functional cells, and memory cells, they will remain in the body of the host for a longer period of time, and effector cells, they will try to eliminate the foreign microorganism or any antigen. Next step is elimination of microbes. These effector cells, they will try to eliminate the microbes, and after successful elimination of microbes, there is a decline and termination of immune response. And memory cells, they are long-lived. They will remain in the body of the host for a longer period of time, and this is called as immunological memory. B lymphocytes produce antibodies that neutralize and eliminate extracellular microbes and toxins. The main function of B lymphocytes is production of antibodies, and these antibodies, they will neutralize and eliminate extracellular microbes and toxins. And T lymphocytes, they will eradicate intracellular microbes. Everyone's immune system is different, but as a general rule, it becomes a stronger during adulthood, as by this time we have been exposed to more pathogens and developed more immunity. That is why teenagers and adults tend to get sick less often than children and older people. Once an antibody has been produced, a copy remains in the body, so that if the same antigen appears again, it can be dealt with more quickly. Therefore, acquired immunity is stronger in response, and it is very rapid in its response. That is why with some diseases such as chickenpox, you only get it once, as the body has a chickenpox antibody stored, which is ready and waiting to destroy it next time it arrives. This is called immunity. Dear students, in next class, next video, I am going to explain about the different types of immune cells. Thank you.